Historically, sometimes if a patient or family member might accept a physician's views or opinions as gospel and not question or not seek to participate or not might not be invited to participate, I think that's perhaps where we've made some advances. And it would seem to me maybe the best blend might be a situation where we would have an active partnership with our patients and maybe take a more active role in kind of connecting with our patients, not just in our office and providing good whole person care, but also in the community as well. I would say in that paternalistic model, perhaps it was more the physician saying, you know, do what I say. I think in maybe the new model of healthcare, it's trying to engage the patient to say, you know, what do you want to do? What do you feel you're prepared to do? And how can I help you in that process? We say that trust is really a cardinal feature of the doctor-patient relationship, that patients need to be able to trust that when they come to the doctor, their doctor is going to be available, that the doctor is going to be willing to meet with them, to listen to them, to attempt to comprehend their perspective and what they're experiencing. And they have to have the trust in being able to fully disclose to assist the physician really in making a good therapeutic relationship and also really assisting them in making an accurate clinical diagnosis. It's really a joy that we have here, I think, to work with learners at all levels. We work with high school students, college, pre-medical students, medical students, residents, and fellows, and I think we're part of a community of learners here. You really ask the students to sort of consider for themselves how would they like to be treated as a patient in a setting that may be very foreign and frightening for our patient.